Hey, remember a few months ago when I said this?
The only movies I think might have a chance of beating it are Tenet.
Yeah, me too. Okay, Chris, I get it now. This is all a joke. You have the real Tenet hidden somewhere. Very funny, but come on, let's see it. Look, I really like Christopher Nolan. He's made a lot of good movies. The Dark Knight's my second favorite movie ever. And even his lesser works by his standards I like, such as Following, Insomnia, and The Dark Knight Rises. For a long time, I'd say he's never made a bad movie. Until now. It honestly upsets me to say that he's finally made a movie I don't like. Tenet is about the protagonist. No, really, that's his name. Having to stop World War III, and there's like this time inversion stuff. All you need to know is that it's a generic save the world from the terrorist plot made even more complicated. This movie might just have the longest second act I've ever seen. I could not keep myself invested, and all the time stuff didn't help any. I could easily sit through The Dark Knight Rises and Interstellar, both of which are almost 3 hours long, but it took me forever to get through this 2.5 hour long movie. I was able to follow Inception quite well, but I couldn't make sense of this, probably because I wasn't invested enough. And if I'm not invested in the story or the characters, I can barely try to figure out what's even going on. The characters don't help either. John David Washington is the protagonist, and he's in this fight because reasons, and that's all you get. Robert Pattinson plays Neil, the protagonist's partner, and all I know is that his name is Neil because I remember hearing the protagonist say it like once. And Elizabeth Debicki plays Kat, and she probably has the most development of the characters, but I don't care about her either. And then we have Kenneth Branagh as a Russian arms dealer. I could not think of a more generic villain, even if I tried. This isn't really his year, is it? And what is it with Hollywood and Russian villains? Also, at points the dialogue was hard to understand, probably because I was watching a cam rip. But watching it on a computer doesn't mean your ears will be violently assaulted by. But you don't really get to see the spectacle of the movie as you would in the theater. Overall, Tenet is an extremely disappointing movie for me, which is really sad because this is something I was really looking forward to. Maybe in the future I'll rewatch it and get something more out of it. But for now, I'm giving Tenet a 4 out of 10. Not the worst movie of the year so far, but definitely the most disappointing. By the way, the next video will be the X-Men ranking, then I'll make the Christopher Nolan ranking.